Hello, I'm Cecile Richards, president of Planned Parenthood Federation of America. I want to be really clear. The allegation that Planned Parenthood profits in any way from tissue donation is not true.
What would you expect for intact tissue? What sort of compensation? What sort of...
Well, why don't you start by telling me what you used to pay?
We'll be exhibiting at the Medical Directors Council meeting in a couple of weeks, so I don't know if you'll be attending.
I'm now the president of that organization.
Oh.
So we had just started the conversation, and SUSE was explaining they're a startup, that they have been about a year in business. They're a for-profit company that's connecting researchers with people willing to donate tissue. Our volume, thank you for giving it to me, is 800 a year, with 60 in the second trimester. And we just started to talk about how the process worked with Novogenics down in Los Angeles when I was there.
Okay.
To back up a little bit, PPFA, our parent body, is on board with tissue donation, but we have to ask for a waiver to do it, and we have to lay out for them what our program's going to be like. And the mechanics of it was that Heather, Novogenics person, would come to the site, and our staff would sign the patients up and get consent, and then Heather would look at the tissue and take what she required. So it was logistically very easy for us. We didn't have to do anything. So it was compensation for this. And there was a discussion as I was leaving. They had been paying by the case, and there was some discussion about doing it in a different way, or I don't know what you're used to doing, how are you used to doing compensation. The patients don't get anything, of course.
Okay, so I'd like, what would you expect for intact tissue? What sort of compensation? What sort of...
Well, why don't you start by telling me what you used to pay?
Okay. I don't think so. I would like to know what would make you happy. What would work for you?
You know, in negotiations, the person who throws out the figure first is at a loss, right? So.
No, I don't look at it that way. I know. You want to play that game, I get it. But
I want lowball, because I'm used to low things from...
You know what? If you lowball, I'll act pleasantly surprised, and you'll know it's a lowball.
Okay.
What I want to know is what would work for you. Don't lowball it.
Okay.
Tell me what you really...
$75 a specimen.
Oh, that's way too low. That's way too low. I want to keep you happy.
I've been at places that did 50 too. But see, we're not in it for the money. So why don't you start by telling me what you used to pay? $75 a specimen. And we don't want to be in the position of being accused of selling tissue and stuff like that. On the other hand, there are costs associated with the use of our
space
and all that kind of stuff. So what would you think about?
Right. So. Way higher than that.
Mm-hmm.
So I'd like to start at around 100.
Okay. Now this is for tissue that you actually take, not just the tissue that the person volunteered that you can't find anything. Right?
Exactly.
Now this is for tissue that you actually take, not just the tissue that the person volunteered that you can't find anything. Right?
Exactly. Right. What we can use? What is intact? So that's why I'm saying no, don't lowball. I want you to be happy.
Well, it's complicated by the fact that our volume is so low, too. I mean, are you looking at 8 and 9 week specimens or only second trimester specimens?
You know, 10 to 12 week, you know, end of the first trimester, if those are pretty intact specimens, then that's something we can work with.
So that's an interesting concept. Let me explain to you a little bit of a problem, which may not be a big problem.
Mm-hmm.
If our usual technique is suction at 10 to 12 weeks, and we switch to using an IPAS or something with less suction in order to increase the odds that will come out as an intact specimen, then we're kind of violating the protocol that says to the patient, we're not doing anything different in our care of you. And to me, that's a kind of a specious little argument, and I wouldn't object to asking Ian, who's our surgeon who does the cases, to use an eye pass at that gestational age in order to increase the odds that he was going to get an intact specimen. But I do need to throw it out there as a concern, because the patient is signing something and we're signing something saying we're not changing anything in the way we're managing you just because you agreed to give tissue. I've heard of that before.
It's
touchy. Okay. How do you feel about that?
I think, they're both totally appropriate techniques. There's no pain involved. Mm-hmm. I don't think the patients would care one iota. Mm-hmm. So I'm not making any fuss about that.
Okay. Okay.
Now you have my email address.
I've got your email. Okay. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Write me a 3 or 4 paragraph proposal, which I will then take to Laurel and others in our organization to see if we want to pursue this. And then if we want to pursue this mutually, I'll mention this to Ian in terms of how he feels about using a less crunchy technique to get more whole specimens. And then if we agree to move forward, the next steps, I need to apply to PPFA for a waiver to permit us to do this. We have to have a contract. Do you have a contract already?
What we've used in the past is a materials transfer agreement. And that's obviously open to discussion.
So that's a prototype. It needs to say exactly what your staff is going to do, exactly what your expectations are, exactly what your compensation is.
And are we agreed that $100 would keep you happy?
Well, let me agree to find out from other affiliates in California what they're getting. And if they're getting substantially more, then we can discuss it again.
Yes.
But yeah. The money is not the important thing.
No.
To be big enough that it's
but it is something to talk about. I mean, it's one of the first things that you brought up, right? So.
Now, here's another thought: is we can talk about specimen per case, or per procured tissue sample, which would be, so if we're able to get a liver thymus pair, maybe that is $75 per specimen, and so that's for liver thymus pair, and that's $150, versus if we can get liver thymus, brain hemisphere, and all that, and so that protects us so that we're not paying for what we can't use. Maybe illustrates things.
It's been years since I've talked about compensation, so let me just figure out what others are getting, and if this is in the ballpark, then that's fine. If it's still low, then we can talk about that. I want a Lamborghini. I want a Lamborghini.
Don't we all, right?
Yeah, exactly.